class. This is your favorite English teacher, Mr. Eaton, and today you have come to me. You come here for some of the questions for part 4 of The Glass Castle. I'm going to answer the first 10, and then on the next video, the next 15, to get all of part 4 done. So it'll be a 2-part video in a bit. So here we go. Question number 1. What is the difference between Jeanette's first interaction with people from Welsh to people from New York? She's starting to notice that people from New York are a little distant, but once they trust you, they tend to talk to you a little bit more. Whereas in Welsh, it's like the moment they arrived, it's fighting time. Time to fight. Welcome to Fight Club. Number 2. What was Jeanette's first job? She worked at a burger joint. She really liked the fast pace of it. She made twice as much as she used to, $80 an hour. How did her parents inadvertently teach her the value of a job? Because they never had a job and they lived in shambles. Jeanette knew she never wanted to live like that. So in a way, her parents taught her inadvertently the value of a job. Number 3, how was the apartment in the South Bronx? Super terrible, yet a huge step up from what they're used to. It's still a bad apartment. There's still like paint peeling from the wall. It's still small, but they got running water. They've got a toilet. They have heat. They have a fridge. Things that they've never really had in Welch. So it's a step up, 100%. They can deal with all the other stuff because I've already dealt with stuff like that. Bugs? Not a problem. Let's kill them. Number 4. Jeanette gets the job at the Phoenix. How? She doesn't have a degree. How did Rufus help her get that job? The person that they were interviewing for the job originally was freaked out because a rat showed up, but Jeanette didn't even flinch. So Rufus the rat was able to help Jeanette by, like, it's not even a big deal. It's just a rat. She was able to get the job. She was already volunteering there to begin with, so she was the likely choice. 5, Jeanette goes from making 40 to 80 and now 125. Tell Jeanette, good job. Number 6, how are things in Welsh? Pretty bad, actually. Mareem is basically living in other people's places at the moment. And dad and mom, in and out of jobs, still drunk, still not doing anything. And who is now going to be moving to the South Bronx? That is Brian. Brian is convinced right away. What? Jeanette got accepted to an Ivy League school. Tell her good job. 8, what happens to Mareem in Welsh? She falls down the steps. She cracks her head open. What does Lori decide is the best decision? Bring her over. Bring her over to New York. She can go to a New York school. And what is Rex's opinion of said decision? He claims that Lori has stolen all of her kids. He feels like a complete failure now. Number 9, what happened on the freeway? Well, they are listening to the news and there's a car that breaks down in the middle of the freeway. Just so happens to be Jeanette's parents, Rex and Mary. They're on the way. And where did Jeanette hear said news? On the radio. And who is now in New York? Rex and Mary. Number 10, the last question for this video. Number 10, where do mom and dad live at first? They live at their own place. Where does dad start living? At Brian's. And how did dad get kicked out of said place? Stealing liquor? Stealing all that booze? Get kicked out. So that is number 10. Huh? Let's keep going. Number 11, how does mom and dad's lives spiral out of control? Because they're always in their own little world and they blame everyone. They don't really have any control. What they do. Are we supposed to feel bad for them because they're living on the streets? I don't know. I want to know your opinion. Anyways, that was questions 1 through 11. Bonus question there. You're welcome. Keep watching these videos so that you can get answers to the questions. I have been your favorite English teacher, Mr. Eaton, signing out. Like and subscribe.